this turned out perfectly. Not the first try. Nothing but sangria, Animal Crossing, and an empty apartment. This stuff's amazing. If I ever quit my job, I'd make a fortune in the winery. Or maybe I'd become a bootlegger. A whole night with the place to myself. This is gonna be the best night ever. What the? Oh. It's only you. I almost had a heart attack. I thought for a split second we were getting robbed. I wasn't expecting you back so early. Did you forget your phone? No? Wait. This was the date from that app, right? Oh. So I take it that things didn't go well. Here. Come and sit. So, what happened? A bad joke? Impromptu marriage proposal? Anything? What? He never even showed up? Are you sure he didn't get lost in traffic or something? What excuse did he give you when you called? He blocked you? Look, I know you probably don't want to hear this, but it does sound like you dodged a bullet there. Even in my less mature days, if I planned a date and I didn't want to go, I'd tell them myself. What kind of jerk just ghosts someone like that? It's ridiculous. Hmm? Hey, Rumi. Are you alright? I'm sorry. Maybe it's a little too soon for me to be bad-mouthing this guy. I'll give you a little space and go back into my room. Are you sure? Okay. If you really want me to, then I'll stay. I made sangria. Let me get you some. Not to keep bashing the guy, but that one time we met, he seemed kinda flaky to me. And I don't know, he just gave off this sketchy vibe. Oh. I'm not a good judge of character? Really? Give me one example. You're never gonna let me live that one down, are you? One time. I had a one-night stand and woke up missing $300. Well, I learned a valuable lesson, though. Never keep that much cash in one place and think with my brain instead of, well, my hormones. Here, taste this. It's incredible, isn't it? Just okay? I'll let that slide just this once because I know you're having a bad day. Got all dressed up and sexy for nothing. No, I didn't mean it that way. I meant, like, the hair and the outfit and, you know, everything. It's not every day that I see you like this. That's all. So, anyway, the point is, dating can be sometimes complicated. People are complex. You can do everything right, but if the other person doesn't do their part, it won't work. And when that happens, the only thing you can do is get back out there and try again in your own time. I don't know. Maybe that is why I'm single right now. But I was out there before, but one day, I realized it wasn't fun for me anymore. You meet someone, go out for a while, break up, and do it all over again. Like running on a hamster wheel. constantly moving but getting nowhere. I'm much happier right now with my work, my hobbies, and, with you. You know, hanging out, because you're such a great roommate. You always pay your half of the rent on time. You never leave the dishes in the sink or hair in the shower drain. And most importantly, you always know how to make me laugh. What am I gonna do when you move out? Well, of course, at some point you'll leave. What? After tonight you'll never leave? No, don't be like that. Tonight was a bust. But eventually you're gonna meet someone and have a whirlwind of a storybook romance and live happily ever after. And I'll still be here on this couch drinking sangria. Hmm? What? Yes, of course. You can ask me anything. Yes, and I'll tell the truth. What's up? When I said you were sexy, did I mean it? Oh god, I'm digging myself into such a deep hole tonight. Of course, I meant it. You're hot. A total catch. Is that what you want to hear? Oh, you meant, do I think of you in a romantic way? Well, I did say I'd be honest. If I tell you this, do you promise not to think of me as some kind of creep? Okay then, here goes nothing. So, remember that time when, I accidentally walked in on you in the shower? I told you I didn't see anything, but, I actually saw way more than I let on. I like to make it less awkward, of course. I wanted to keep some semblance of privacy between us. And for a while after that, all I could think about was you. Fully clothed, of course, but yeah. We get along great, and we have so much fun even when it's just the two of us. So, yeah, I have thought about us in that way. What? Oh, God. Yes, I saw you naked. Is that the only thing you got from my heartfelt confession? I think you've had enough to drink for one night. I'm going to bed now. Why? Because if I stay here with you any longer, I won't have any secrets or dignity left. Besides, you seem positively jovial now. My work here is done. Can I... What are you doing? Let go of my arm, please. Why not? Really? You're gonna whisper it to me? Fine. I'll get closer. Now what do you want? Even closer? No, I don't want to get any closer. Because we're impossibly close already. We might as well be kiss... Oh. Is that what this is all about? I confessed to you one of my deepest secrets and now you're half drunk and want to kiss? You know what? Fine. If it'll get you to stop asking me embarrassing questions and go to bed, then yes, I'll do it. I highly doubt you'll remember much about this tomorrow, anyway. Close your eyes, you goofball. All the way closed, please. Okay. Ready? 3, 2, 1. There. You got your kiss. Now go to bed. Oh. Completely unexpected. Wait, where are you going? Yes, I wanted to go to bed, but not if you're mad at me. What is it? You're right. That probably wasn't the best choice of words. Obviously, I've been having a lot of difficulty with that tonight. What I meant to say was that it was unexpected. In a good way. Unexpected, but not unwanted. Trust me, it was very much wanted. Now get back over here. Scary, crossing that line. Having so much to gain and so much to lose at the same time. Maybe everything will work out perfectly and we'll be telling this story at family reunions for the next 50 years. Maybe it won't work out and I'll be looking for a new roommate this time next year. But what I know, right now, is that I'm willing to take the chance. No matter what ends up happening. What about you? Hey? Oh, for the love of... Did you really fall asleep in my arms? Not only that, but standing up. I guess it really is time for bed. I'll just put you here, on the couch, and put my arm around you. Then we can wake up together and get breakfast.